Russia has likely lost a third of its forces on the ground. That's according to the latest intelligence assessment from the United Kingdom's Defense Ministry. Behind me right now, you're looking at what Ukrainian forces say was an attack on an entire Russian battalion trying to cross a river in the east. The Ukrainians said they destroyed the pontoons and thwarted 9 crossing attempts. You can see the damage the Ukrainians there are bringing to the Russian forces. And this is just one example across the wide range of the battlefield. Joining me now to talk about this is Steve Hall, CNN intelligence analyst and former national security analyst, former CIA chief of Russia operations. Steve, great to see you here. A third of its military strength, the UK says Russia's lost. What do you make of that?
To put it in the most simple terms, it continues to go very poorly for Russia in Ukraine, and especially along these areas that they really hope to be able to control. Now, we've already seen, you recall the previous chapter, where the Russians, you know, at first said, we're going to take it all and we're going to end up in Kiev and other places in the West. They've clearly abandoned that. They decided to refocus on the East and on the Southeast. And now it's going badly for them as well. As a matter of fact, the Russians are now saying, well, it might not be both Luhansk and Donetsk that we can take. It might just be part of that Donbas region. So it keeps getting dialed back further and further.
It really is interesting. I mean, the Russians lost here, they lost here, they lost here. And now in Kharkiv, they've been pushed back substantially. And we have this new video I can show you right here in the big wall here of Ukrainian forces. They're at the border, they say, in this picture. The Russian border, Ukrainian-Russian border, saying, Mr. President, to President Zelensky, you know, we're here. We've made it all the way.
I mean, videos like this just show you the height of morale and the professionalism that we're seeing in the Ukrainian side, which the reporting that we're now getting also indicates that that's not happening on the Russian side. You're not seeing this sort of celebratory type of thing where they're maintaining their borders. So this is a big deal because the will to fight is so important. And as young Russian men get conscripted in more and more, you're going to have, I think, more of a morale issue for the Russians, much less so for the Ukrainians.
Some of these pictures will make it one way or another inside Russia. I want to talk about what's happening with NATO, because both Finland and Sweden right now, have taken more of the official steps to join NATO. And this is something that Russia says it's very concerned about. Basically, their deputy foreign minister says, don't expect us to take this lying down. You spent so many years, you know, working in, around, covering Russia for the CIA. How big of it is it a deal? How big of a deal is it with Finland joining NATO?
This is a huge deal. I mean, you can see the border here. I mean, it's an over 800-mile border with Russia. Who would have thought 3 months ago, with both of these countries, Sweden and Finland, proclaiming their neutrality as they've done for so many decades since World War II. Their judgment was, look, it's best if we try not to aggravate Russia too much. Of course, now that Russia has become so aggressive against Ukraine, against Georgia, against other places in the neighborhood, these countries are now saying, well, hold on a second, Vladimir Putin, because of your actions and solely because of your actions, we are now going to try to get into the NATO alliance because, of course, we're concerned. And Finland, of course, has had the winter war with Russia, where they lost quite a bit of territory. So it's no surprise that both these countries are very interested.
Do you think Russia would attack Finland to stop it from happening?
You know, there's always the overblown Russia propaganda. Oh, we're going to have to rearrange forces. We're going to have to take this very seriously. In fact, they will move some forces around, but there's not going to be much of a tactical impact. It's mostly propaganda, as it usually is with Putin.
Steve Hall, great to see you. Thank you very much.
Sure. Russia may have lost as much as a third of its ground forces it committed to the Ukrainian invasion. CNN's Claire Sebastian joins us live from London on this part of the story. Claire, what else have we learned from this British Defense Intelligence assessment?
Yeah, Laura, this would be a significant problem, obviously, for the Russian forces in Ukraine if they had lost a third of their ground forces. We don't know exactly how the UK Defence Ministry arrived at that estimate. The latest estimate before this from the British Defence Minister was 15,000 Russian casualties. That was at the end of April. So if you imagine that there were about 150,000 Russian troops on the border of Ukraine before the invasion, according to US and Ukrainian intelligence sources, that would be a significant uptick if we're talking about a third of that. But they're not just talking about the loss of people in this assessment. They're talking about critical losses of equipment, what they call enabling equipment, things like bridging equipment, drones, everything that sort of enables a swift advance in a military context. They're saying that the Russian forces have lost a significant amount of that kind of equipment, and that is what is slowing them down. That coupled with low morale as well. And that is leading the British intelligence and the defense ministry to say that they're not expecting Russia to dramatically accelerate their advance over the next 30 days. So clearly a difficult situation as they tried to focus on the Donbas and the Ukrainian resistance really steps up.
All right, Claire, thank you.